To ensure a thorough assessment, it is best to perform the musculoskeletal exam of the knee in a systematic way. The following is a suggested order of exam that incorporates many of the common techniques used for evaluating knee injuries. Begin the exam with the patient in the standing position. Look for evidence of gross deformity, muscular atrophy, symmetry of the patellar alignment, evidence of varus or valgus positioning of the knee, or presence of pes planus and pes cavus of the foot. From a posterior view, observe for more than two toes laterally, also called the too many toes sign. This can indicate an overpronated foot or an abducted forefoot. Have the patient perform a toe raise and evaluate the heel position. Normally, the heel should change from a neutral to a varus position. Next, observe the gait, looking for an antalgic gait or excessive pronation or supination. Next, evaluate active range of motion. If pain or limitation exists, repeat the range of motion passively. In a seated position, test for knee extension. In this position, also observe patellar tracking. And internal and external rotation of the hip, which can help identify referred knee pain caused by hip pathology. Also in the seated position, palpate anatomic landmarks for tenderness. Palpate the distal quadriceps, quadriceps tendon, the patella, and patellar tendon. The tibial tuberosity, and the fat pads beneath the patella. On the medial side, palpate the medial collateral ligament, the medial joint line, the pes anserine bursa, and on the lateral side, the lateral collateral ligament, the lateral joint line, and the fibular head. Posteriorly, palpate the popliteal fossa and the distal hamstrings.